Peace. Can you hear me? This is Queen Ifama. I am the Truth Terrorist. And I wanted to do this last end of the year video for 2011 just to reflect on some of the things that I've seen over the year. And one of the highlights is the bashing of the black woman. I've seen so much of that on YouTube, and as I listen to these various talk shows and blogs, talk shows, and you know, and this is basically coming from black men, and they're not totally, you know, in the wrong for what they say. It's because it's the things that they see, and they're very skillful at pulling out the worst video that they can find of black women and displaying them, you know, and using the caption, you know, and of all black women or black women period, instead of, you know, differentiating those women that they find in disdain and those women that they think are the quote unquote good black women. And I just think it's really, really sad, because the media itself has done a job on black people, period. And I think that what a lot of black women do, you know, the way they walk, the way they dress, the way they act, the way they wear their hair, you know, it is to appeal to the black man. And she, you know, over exaggerates herself because she wants to be admired and desired by him. And so from what I've looked at, you know, and being a woman myself, you know, back in the, you know, because I'm older, so it was back in the day, and I kind of look back on that time and analyze why I would wear certain types of dress and what was my mindset back then. And I remember the clothes that I would wear, it was basically to attract black men, because I saw that is what black men liked, okay? And, you know, the ones who are doing the most complaining are the ones who's looking at the booties out, the breasts out, the long hair. Those are the ones that they're going after, if only just to use her or just to have sex with her. These are the black men who are going after these women, who may at some point spur them, tell them to get the fuck on, or, you know, just say something derogatory or you know, ignore their advances, and then that's when they become very critical of them. But, you know, like I was saying, these women dress the way they dress because you're attracted to that kind of dress. When they see you eyeballing another woman that looks like that, then they assume that's what you like. So for the most part, you know, and I think I did a video on who do you dress for. And I think for the most part that black women, particularly those you see that, you know, expose themselves like that, that, and that's their damn business, but I'm just doing a video about it. They are really doing it for the attention of men. You know, some people have attention disorders. You know what I'm saying? They seek attention all the time, and they know that that kind of dress gets the attention of a man, whether it's for their benefit or their detriment at the end of the day. You know, it's kind of like a child who seeks attention. It doesn't matter if the attention is negative or if it's positive. All they want is attention. So I think that if brothers would not pay attention to those type of women, if those aren't the type of women that, you know, make their penis rise up and they have more control over their penises, they would not encourage that type of display. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, and if women knew that men preferred a more, how can I put it? Demurely, I would say. Okay, I use demure, demurely dressed woman. You know, then I think maybe sisters would adhere to that. If they thought that you liked their kinky ass hair better, and that you know they were being disregarded by black men because they, you know, the men don't like the weaves and they don't like the all that other kind of stuff they say, then maybe they would wear their hair in the natural state. You know, I don't have a problem with wearing different hair, as you know. And I really could give two shits about what a man thinks about my hair. Really, I don't. And up to this point, I've never had a problem, you know, with men, the men in my life, and my choice of hair. Okay, I've always dressed decently, you know, as far as I'm concerned. Even, I think even younger, you know, I still kind of did the peekaboo breast thing, and you know, I've worn shorts, but not hot pants before, and I've worn short skirts, but for the most part, I've been a pants type person, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, and when I look at these things, I look at the fact that these women want to be desired by men, basically, and that's why they dress like that. And you know, it's really sad to see how, you know, some brothers, and I think this got a lot to do with the hatred, you know, some kind of disgust for the woman of today, and you lump all women in that category, and because it's, I guess it's kind of hard to differentiate when you don't know how. But, you know, I think it's really sad that, you know, you talk about exploitation, but you're exploiting these women for the sake of videos, you know, so you can make a sensational video that's anti-black woman. And these are the things that I've been seeing, you know, on the YouTube and on television, you know, about women who have been neglecting their children, and, you know, the types of dances that are done. You think that's something new. I remember looking at a documentary of women in the 40s. This was in the 1940s. And you know that dance where the woman turns around and rubs her butt up against the man's front of the man? Well, they were doing that in the 40s. They were doing pussy shaking in the 40s. Okay, on the dance floor. I mean, I saw it live, a video. I'm telling you, real people, black people that danced like that back then. But we had a moral code that would put those types of people in a certain kind of category. Okay, they were called loose, they were called wild, but they weren't disrespected in their communities. I mean, that was just something they did. But today, you got this worldwide web where these types of behaviors are splattered across the media, the screen, and then you have black women trying to come on and defend black womanhood. You know what I'm saying? Just because they are women, they want to come on and defend black womanhood and make sure that you know that they're not one of them, when you're putting all of them in the same category. You see what I'm saying? I mean, just by the video that you did. I mean, at the end of this year, just looking back, I've seen so many things. And like I said, the highlight for me was the anti-woman campaign, as well as this thing, the black woman is God and the black man is God. And I think all of those things have been taken out of context. And I think people say those things so that they can elevate their own selves without a real concept of what God is. Because they're thinking of God in a, I'm gonna say this because this is what I think, in a theological way, the way that they were raised to believe that God is perfect, all-knowing, a creator, you know, and so forth and so on. And I've learned, you know, up to this point that definitely isn't what God is to me. You know what I'm saying? I'm as far as this entity, one entity called God, I don't believe in that. I believe that we're all gods sleeping, and that in our human state is where we display all of the negativity that we have within ourselves. But when we begin to elevate ourselves from our lower selves, our lower nature, which is, you know, the human state, we begin to rise to a God state. And that is the rise to perfection, whereas you stand on your square. See, and this is the thing about perfection. Perfection is you perfect self. And perfecting self, to me, means that you take responsibility for all that you do. You don't give it to the devil. You don't give it to God, this entity called God or the devil. You don't give it to the white man. You don't give it to the system. You don't give it to the black woman. You don't give it to the white man, the black man. You stand on your square for every decision that you make, and you accept the consequences of your decision, period. To me, that's what God is. You know, I mean, if you don't raise your children the way that they'll be able to operate and move around in the world with other people, don't blame the system. Don't blame God, and don't blame the devil. Don't blame your mama. Don't blame your daddy, but blame yourself. Because what you forgot is that you're responsible for bringing that child in the world. You were the vehicle. So that responsibility is on you to raise this child better than you were raised. If you were raised in a negative environment, you should remember that and not want to subject your child to the same thing, instead of you using the same excuse like everybody else who does some fucked up shit and say, oh, well, I'm a product of a bad environment. And you know that? See, if you can recognize that you are a product of a bad environment, then you know that you're a product of a bad environment, which means you know what a bad environment is, which means you know how you can get out of a bad environment. But see, a lot of times we want to wallow in the bad environment because it feels good. And then we want to produce fucked up results, and we want to blame it on from whence we come. And I'm saying that's bullshit. You know what I'm saying? I know people who have lived under horrendous circumstances and came out of it and raised children to be decent individuals in the world. So I don't be wanting to hear that shit about your environment. You didn't have a daddy. Your mama abandoned you. You're a grown, standing on your own 2 feet human being. It's time for you to take responsibility for the shit you do, good or bad. Yeah, I mean, it's just as simple as that. Life does not get any simpler than that for me. I had to learn that, though, and I wish someone had told me earlier, you know, got that through my head earlier, but I got it now. And see, I know what I should do and what I shouldn't do. What results it's going to bring me and what it will not bring me. I knew long time ago that fucking with drugs, you'll mess around and get a habit if you keep messing around with drugs. I'm talking drugs like heroin and cocaine, not marijuana, but heroin and cocaine. I looked at the example around me. I mean, it didn't take me to be a rocket scientist to figure that out, It was when I got into my 20s that I began to have more respect for my body, okay? Earlier than that, my body, I just used my body because he liked me, so he wanted to have me, so I'll give myself to him and then he'll like me. Bullshit, that didn't happen, you know? I'm just saying, now I take responsibility for that shit. I made those choices. I made those choices to give myself to people that did not have my best interest. And as I look back, I think I realized it from the beginning. I just did not know how to listen to that little voice that told me, this nigga means you no good. You know what I'm saying? And I thought that if I gave him this of me, that he would love me and want to be with me. And it just didn't work out like that. I mean, it just doesn't work out like that. You know, I'm learning that men are funny creatures. And the more you give in, and I can't just say as men, I think this is, you know, conducive, you know, like this is something all human beings do. You know, they'll try you. And if you allow them, they will use you. You know what I'm saying? They will use you unless they have some moral fiber in them that doesn't allow them to use people in the first place. But these are things that I had to learn and that I want to share, because I think that particularly for women, because we can get so emotional about these things. And as a woman, you know, I am saddened by the display and the constant depiction of women, certain women, certain types of women who, you know, go on camera and display themselves like that, and then get mad when people say something to them about it. And I'm like, you made the decision to do it. So now you have to either suffer the consequences or rejoice in the consequences, because some of them think it's like a badge of honor. But what they don't realize is the mindset of the society does not hold that kind of behavior in a respectful state. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, back in the 40s, 50s, and 60s, when I was coming up, women who acted like that were loose women. Okay, and like I said, they weren't disrespected like they are today. Like, you know, and I think that's because of these social medias that they have, you know, and the videos that are able to produce and display them. You know what I'm saying? And the webcams and the phone cameras that can capture all the negative images of these women. And sometimes all you got to do is go into a club and you could get so much footage of negative behavior on the parts of women, and you will see men standing around. Sometimes I'm telling you, it's so sad. You know, you can see images of men, but nobody is ever castigating those men for standing around and encouraging that kind of behavior. Those men aren't turning away and, you know, not paying them any attention. They're clapping them on while in their heads they're trying to figure out which one of them they might be able to get to wet their penises that night, but have no intention of having a relationship or building a relationship with that woman, whichever one he decides to go with. So basically, you know, these women, you know, they set themselves up to be used because of the desire to be wanted and to be desired by these very men who stand around with drinks in hand and watch them, you know, bear themselves and gyrate themselves on and do it on camera. And know a camera is on, okay, but still do it, you know. And I don't feel sorry for them, because they're making a conscious decision to do that. Okay, who I will hold accountable is the ones who cheer them on. Why do you cheer them on? Let you know, if you don't like those kind of women, then don't be around those kind of women. Let them women know that I don't mess with women like you. I guarantee you, because, you know, you try to put all the blame on women, but I'm going to tell you, brothers, if you decide that as a group that we're not going to deal with women like that, and you start turning your head to them women, I'm telling you, they'll begin to see the answer and see the light when they see the other sisters that you do have some respect for, who do not bear themselves like that, who take care of their business every day, who are raising their children, even though they may be single parents, you know, because we have single parents all the time, male and female. And with the woman, you know, there are various circumstances why the father of those children are not with her, okay? And that varies, so you can't use one instance to cover everybody. But what I'm saying is there are women who are single parents who are good and who do raise their children to be decent human beings and who do put their children first. And their desires and needs and wants are secondary to the needs of their children. So, you know, these are like things that I've seen, you know, in video and listened to this year in particular, which is what I'm talking about, the closeout of 2011. And I'm gonna tell you the truth, I really don't see things getting any better. I really don't see the particularly with women, because you know the first thing we'll say is, well, I can do what I want, I can wear my hair like I want, and you know what, they most certainly can, they can, but it is the one who they're trying to attract that has the power to make them, you know, maybe not make them but persuade them to change the way that they're behaving and acting. You know what I'm saying? If they are looking for meaningful relationships, a man to love them, respect them, and cherish them, then, you know, they're gonna have to change the way they do things. I mean, you can't have it both ways. That's just the butt naked truth. You know, and, you know, I've seen so many videos and news accounts of how women are treating their children, and I mean, it's just really a sad, sad thing to see. It's as though, you know, we've gotten more educated, we've gotten more financially stronger, but it seems like our moral character, for the most part, and I'm not gonna say everybody, so I'm just really focusing on these women who are highlighted in these videos displaying, these are everyday women, they're not doing this for no money, you know, who are displaying themselves to the public for free, okay? I can see if it was part of their earned income, but they're doing this shit for free, and that's for attention and attention only. And like I say, you have men who cheer them on, but then go and put up a video about them and talk about how bad they are, how nasty they are, how decadent they are. But you males are still supporting and encouraging that kind of behavior just for your own entertainment. And I'm saying that, it, you know, while they have responsibility, you have responsibility as well. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, I just feel so, I don't know. I just feel like a loss for humanity itself, you know, and the children that these women bear. I mean, I'm like, where are your children while you're in the club with what I would call bathing suit clothes on? You know what I'm saying? I mean, they showed this video about this young girl who made this prom dress, and the people at the school said, hell no, you can't wear that up in here. You know what I'm saying? I'm telling you, prom dresses done went they almost like strip club dresses. You know what I'm saying? Where's the parent, the mother of these young women? Like I said, you know, some of these women, I don't know, they have children, and I don't know why their creator blessed them with that capability, and they don't have a clue as to the importance of motherhood. You know, they want to brag about the woman being the first teacher, and they can have babies and all that other kind of stuff, but when you look at what the result of that they're raising is, it's sad. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you got 12 and 13 year olds, man. I'm telling you, that's off the chain. And their parents are saying they can't do anything with them. And I'm like, are you serious? But they are serious. You know, they just throw their hands up because they know that. And I'm going to tell you something. I'm going to tell you something too. See, parents suffer from guilt as well, but they'll blame it on the devil. They'll blame it on the society. They'll blame it on peer pressure. They'll blame it on everybody but themselves and the fact that they fell off when it came to raising their children, because a lot of them did not set the examples themselves. You know, I mean, when I was coming up and I would go to my friend's house, because, you know, my mother just did not have that kind of stuff. I mean, it was certain music that we could not play in our houses, in our home. You know, I mean, my mother was just very, very strict like that. And so was I with my daughter. I mean, there were just certain things I just was not going to allow. And it wasn't going to happen. But, you know, my sister was the type who would take the clothes that my mother bought her and would get to school and change clothes with her, and her friends would bring her other clothes to put on that was shorter, tighter, you know, stuff like that. But she was so dumb that, you know, shit have happened at school and she'd have to come home with them clothes on, and my mom saw it and say, hey, where'd you get those clothes from? See, that they'd be stupid. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, like I said, parents got to take responsibility for what they spawned, what they brought to this planet, and how it came out. That's, you know, that's another thing. You know what I'm saying? Because if you set certain values in your child, like I tell everybody, and I'm going to tell you, wouldn't a peer in the world could override what I said, okay? Because my daughter had a level of respect for me and the fact that I knew what I was talking about, because I sat her down and told her, been there, done that. You know what I'm saying? And this is what, you know, people would really think about you. So, you know, I just wanted to do this year in, because I don't see things getting any better. And it appears that, you know, it's just out of control. And I think that it's being more propagandized than it should, which actually encourages that type of behavior. And like I said at the onset, I think that a lot of these women are really doing it for the attention of these men who appear to want that, you know, but really deep down in their hearts, they don't want a woman like that. You know what I'm saying? They want a woman that has some respect for herself. You know, her own person. That's what black men, and I'm speaking to black men, that is what black men want. But, you know, they also want to be able to stick their penises in any and everything that walks back. They have no respect for the woman, but they will have sex with her. You know, so they should stop desiring to have sex with those women, have some control of their own libido, and we will probably see some of this kind of behavior dissipate. Because as it stands, the clubs is jumping with half-naked women, and they're not even on poles and getting tips. So, you know, it's really sad that we have this this society has the whore mentality. And trust me, it's not just black women, but it seems that that's all the footage that they can find is of black women. But I've seen white women just as bad, you know, I'm telling you, just as bad. As a matter of fact, the whole society has based its whole, you know, outlook on the the degradation of the woman, period. You know what I'm saying? In the 60s, they had the sexual revolution where now women can go and have sex just like men and not think of the results, and, you know, which could be a child, or they go and get the birth control so they can have as much sex as they want, not to think that all these men going up in them is causing them harm in their bodies. You know, all that banging and shit in your body, you know, is, your body's not made for that. You know what I'm saying? That's why you have the gynecologists are just like, you know, off the chain. I mean, they highly paid. You know what I mean? Because women have these gynecological problems due to the fact that they're having all of this rough sex with men. And honey, I'ma tell you, the things that I've seen, you know, women want to be spanked and hit and bit and hair pulled and, you know, all that kind of violence. That's just violence to me against women. And women don't get it. You know, as a matter of fact, they've been lulled into thinking that they enjoy that shit. You know, I mean, who in the world, other than a homosexual male, would want a penis up in her rectum and think that that's something good? I'ma spray your butt, talking to my cat. I'm training my little kitty cat because I just got him and he has a habit of jumping up, so I had to spray his ass. But you know, they, you know, it's just like, man, like I said, you can't have it both ways. Either you want respect, and respect is based on this cultural paradigm about women. Either you want that respect, or you want to continue to be, you know, used and treated like a whore. You know, not a prostitute, but a whore. And I don't have anything against women selling their bodies, because we know sex sells, okay? But the way it is not healthy. You know what I'm saying? Because even, you know, prostitutes, even though it's their business, they are disrespected for what they do. You know what I'm saying? Even though men go buy it, they're still disrespected. So, you know, I'm just like really saddened for the state of womanhood that is being visually, produced, and how that is being applied to women, period. And I just think that it's really a sad thing. And, you know, I don't know. Like I said, if men start denouncing it, not paying attention to it, saying, you know, talking about the kind of woman that they want instead of displaying the women that they don't want, the kind of woman that they want. I have yet to see a video that talks about that. You know, a lot of them, because it's a few of them that do. But, you know, for the most part, the videos that I've been looking at are ones that show the black woman or black women at their worst, okay? And I'm saying that there should be more videos of black men saying what kind of woman that they want. And the ones that they don't want, they don't even have anything to do with them. Period. I think that if that happens, we would not have a lot of single parent homes, you know, because the man would have respect and stay with his woman and raise his children with her, and, you know, everything will be hunky dory. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, you can't have your cake and eat it too, man. And, you know, this past year has really been an eye opener for me, as far as the mentality that has developed, or that has developed. It ain't developing, it has developed. And I don't think that things are gonna get any better soon until somebody, either the one who wants to be desired, or the one who is the desirer, that they begin to take a look at, you know, themselves. Because it's, at the end of the day, it still boils down to you. You know, what type of person do you want to present to the world? And it's not people telling you what you should do. It's just a point of what I would consider, and I'm going to use this term, is decency. You know what I'm saying? There's a lack of decency in the society. And it's not just, again, relegated to black people. It's relegated to people, period. And the exploitation of women, period. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you expose your mammary glands. You expose your buttocks. These items, these parts of your body were for nurturing children and sitting in chairs on. You know what I'm saying? But now they're sexual objects. And we'll make the excuse that, oh, well, you know, women walked around bare in Africa. Yeah, they did that, but that's a whole different culture where the breast doesn't arouse the men. You know what I'm saying? Where our ass don't arouse the men. You know what I'm saying? For the most part, not unless they've been in touch with the Western train of thought. You know what I mean? And another thing is that even the religions that we believe in are, you know, degradative of women, or put women in a certain lower class than men are. So, you know, even if men are relegating themselves to a higher level, then I think that they bear a bigger responsibility then they should not be allowing themselves to have those desires for these so-called out of control women. You know what I'm saying? They only encourage it, and it only creates more. The young girls see the older men and the younger guys, what they're looking at and what makes them go, ooh, ah, and all that other kind of stuff. And so they make the decision that, hey, I'm going to look like that too, so I can get some oohs and ahs. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I just wanted to end my YouTube year with this video, because the last thing video I saw, which is what kind of spurred it on, was a video that, you know, depicted the woman in a very negative light. I mean, a series of shots that highlighted these women and was literally castigating these women. But they're also part of the problem because they're putting it on display. You know what I'm saying? And I think that, you know, at some point, someone is going to have to take responsibility for their own desires and what they, you know, what moves them to want to have somebody or be with somebody. You know, and like I said, 9 times out of 10, these men just want to use these women, and then these women give themselves to these men, and they mess around and have children by these men, and these men didn't give two shits about them in the first place because of their initial presentation. So, you know, I'm just saying that if you want to rise to the God state, then you're going to have to take a real deep look at yourself and put your desire in check. Put your sexual inclinations in check. I mean, you got to really check why you like pain during sex, or why you like to give pain during sex. That's sadomasochistic behavior, in my opinion. I mean, I wouldn't want to be hurt by someone in a sexual act that was hurting me. You know what I'm saying? And I've conditioned myself to like it. It's unbelievable. That would make me a masochist, and it would make him a sadist for doing it. So, you know, we got to take responsibility for our own shit, people. You know, you got to quit blaming the society. Quit blaming your mama. Quit blaming your daddy. Quit blaming the educational system. Quit blaming the government. You know what I'm saying? It's your choices that you're making. You decide to put the goddamn thong on and wear it out in the street and expose your buttocks to the world. You know, there is a science behind this whole exposure of the booty. There's a science behind that. That comes, I'm just going to say in my opinion, that comes out of a homosexual thread. You know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, an ass is an ass. So if you get enough women to show their asses, you'll develop a desire for an ass. I'm talking about men. And at the end of the day, it may not matter what that ass looks like. You know, that's why you have men in jail who have sex with men and don't think they're gay. Don't think they're homosexual. You know, they just be, I gotta do what I gotta do just to get off. You know what I'm saying? So I'm telling you, it's a real sick society, man. I'm glad that I've lived to see my ripe old age, you know, and not have succumbed to that depth of deprivation. You know what I'm saying? And like I said, the things that I'm seeing, man, I'm telling you, it's saddening. It saddens me. But I know that there's nothing I could do about it. But, you know, check my own damn self. You know what I'm saying? And know that I've raised a woman who wouldn't dare do that to herself. You know what I mean? But, you know, like I said, man, and I have nieces, you know, that are really decent women. You know, even though one or two may yearn for a companionship, from what I know now, I hope I don't see one of them on these damn videos, you know, but from what I know, they're pretty decent young women. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I'm just saying that I think that at some point, and I'm going to keep saying this, is that you have to take responsibility for your own choices in life. And if you make those choices, then you will suffer the consequences, or you will rejoice in the consequences if they're favorable. So I'm just saying, it's all on you. You know, and when I look at that shit, I look at each and every one of those women in the videos. I look at each and every one of those men in the videos. And I especially look at the one who's filming the shit. Okay? So with that said, this is Queen Ifama closing out the year 2011 with this vid. And you know, I know that some of you may not agree, and I really could give two shits whether you agree with me or not, but I think that at some point these things have to be said so that people can begin to think, because I know that is what helped me, and that is listening, observing, and learning from examples. So that is why I'm putting this video out. It is addressed to both male and female. And the question, to question yourself as to why you engage in the behavior of acting it out and the behavior of supporting it with your cheers, with your presence, and with your video camera. So this is Queen Ifama. I am the Truth Terrorist, and see you in 2012. Peace, everybody.